Hi, this is CAD CAM Lessons channel. This is the next part of the tutorial where I show the basics of creating 3D models in FreeCAD. You will find link to the other parts in the description of this video. If you like this tutorial, leave a subscription and we will move on to the next issues useful at the initial stage of learning FreeCAD and issues useful in creating 3D. Solids. In the previous parts, I showed you that we can create sketches not only on the basic planes of coordinate system, but also on the faces of the solid. Such a face can be a sketch plane. We created sketches on such a face parallel to the XY plane, but we can also create sketches on other faces. In this case, it can be the side face of the solid, but we can also use a tilted face to create a sketch. Here I will create such a face and briefly show the chamfering operation. And chamfering is a simple operation used in creating 3D models. We simply add a chamfer on the selected edge, and in one operation we can add a chamfer on one edge or several selected edges. And in this case I will select this edge, select the chamfer operation, specify a chamfer of 10 millimeters and click OK to confirm it. We have a tilted face and this face can also be a sketch plane. But first we will create a sketch on this face parallel to the YZ plane. Select this face, choose to create a sketch, and now this face is a sketch plane and this face doesn't have to be parallel to the XY plane. And in the first step I select create external geometry and create external geometry based on these two edges. Right click to cancel this command and create a rectangle. Okay, right click to cancel this command and let's add dimensions. Select this dimension and here enter 50 millimeters and select this dimension and here enter 10 millimeters. And I would like to place this rectangle perfectly in the middle of this face. And for this, I can use dimensions or constraints. But using dimensions can be time consuming, so it may be better to use constraints. And for this, some auxiliary geometries can also be useful. And I will draw two lines that will be the axis of symmetry of this face. And let's draw two lines more or less like this. And these lines don't have their position defined yet. I will place this line between these two auxiliary lines so it lies in the middle of this wall. We use the symmetry constraint, select this point and this line and select symmetry constraint. Now this line lies perfectly in the middle of this face. We do the same with the second line. This time select this point and this line and select symmetry constraint. And now I can move this line up and down only. For now we will leave it and focus on placing the rectangle. Let's place this rectangle relative to these lines using the symmetry constraint. Select this point and this line and select symmetry constraint. And now the position of this rectangle in this axis is locked. We can move it up and down but not left and right. And let's add another symmetry constraint relative to this line. And when adding constraints, first make sure no geometry is selected. Sometimes we accidentally select a line or point and then the constraint, and FreeCAD will try to apply this constraint to the selected geometries. And in situation like this, I usually click the left mouse button in the workspace before selecting a command to deselect all geometries. And now select this two points, select this line and select symmetry constraint, and the color of the rectangle has changed to green, but other geometries are white. The sketch is not fully constrained. We have 4 degrees of freedom, but we could leave it like that. But if you want to fully constrain the sketch, we can do it easily. Select these 2 points and select constrain vertically. The same here, select these 2 points, constrain vertically, and the number of degrees of freedom decreases and this geometry turns green, and apply similar constraints for these points. Select this point and select constrain horizontally, and select this point and constrain horizontally. Now the entire sketch is fully constrained. Let's close the sketch, and if you want to add an extrusion based on this sketch, an error appears, because the geometries in the sketch cannot intersect. Let's edit this sketch, and in this sketch we need these two geometries. These lines define the position of the rectangle, and we cannot delete this line. Instead, we can change these geometries to construction geometry. This way, they will be used only in sketch, but not in creating the 3D solid. Select these two lines and select toggle construction geometry. And these lines turn blue. And this means that these lines are only auxiliary geometry in the sketch. Let's close this sketch and add an extrusion. And now it works. Enter 10 millimeters as a length and click OK to accept. And remember, sketches in FreeCAD cannot intersect. And let's create another sketch. And creating sketches on faces parallel to the planes of coordinate system may seem intuitive, but it is no different with an inclined faces. Select this face, select create sketch, and this face is a sketch plane. Let's create a circle with diameter of 8 millimeters. Okay. And place this circle in the middle of this face, and we will use the symmetry constraint, but first let's select create external geometry and select this line and this line. And now, to place this circle in the middle of this face, select this point and this point, and select symmetry constraint. And the center of the circle is placed symmetrically between these 2 points, and it means that this circle is placed in the middle of this face. Let's close this sketch and add another extrusion and click OK. And as you can see, by creating subsequent sketches on the model faces, we can create subsequent stages of the 3D model. And this is how we very often work in 3D CAD systems. That is, we start from a simple shape and add subsequent fragments of the 3D solid and create an increasingly complex and complicated model. And so far we have used the operation of adding material based on a 2D sketch, but the second such basic operation of creating 3D solids in 3D CAD systems is an operation that allows you to remove material based on a 2D sketch. That is, we create a 2D sketch and do the opposite operation to what we have done so far. That is, instead of adding material, we remove material from the existing solid, and we will deal with this in the next part of the tutorial. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and if you don't want to miss the next part of the tutorial, please subscribe to this channel.